Okay, so I highly encourage you to also create a strategy before you go out and spray and pray. You know, create a little bit of a strategy. Visualize what you're going to do. It will really help you make a better application that way. So what I did is, I always recommend, obviously, that you have a property map. I'll link below in the description to videos that I've done that show you how to measure your lawn. That's really the first thing you do when you take on any lawn care program, is you measure your lawn. But either way, the sections that I'm going to be spraying today are section 2 and 3. That's my front lawn. There's weeds in there, and there are zones where I've got nut's edge. That's one of the reasons I'm interested in using this. It's got nut's edge listed on the label, so I want to see how it does on the sedges. It's got a lot of nut's edge in some zones, and then I've got some broadleaf weeds kind of speckled into certain areas around the trees where I think the birds have kind of shat them out, and it's kind of created some weeds in there. So that's going to be mostly spot spraying in those two areas, and those two areas are 4,500 square feet between the two of them, but I'm not going to be blanketing in there. I am going to blanket spray one area though, and it's 1,000 square foot area on the side yard over here. This is covered in sedge, and it's also where I have that day flower that's really thick in there, just spreading out. I showed you guys. So I don't know if day flower is going to get this. It's not a listed weed. It's not a common weed either, but either way, we're going to try it. And that's 1,000 square foot, so I'm going to blanket spray that. So we're going to go with the low mix rate here is 5.2 ounces per gallon, and 1 gallon covers 1,000 square feet. I got that right off of the label by reading it. All right, now I'm sure we'll do more content on actually reading labels and that, but I just want to show you this one and how I came up with the mix rate. So this one's a little bit different in that if you want to go with a low rate, it's 5.2 ounces. This is a liquid concentrate into 1 gallon of water. If you want to use a heavier rate or you want to put down more product, they're saying you need to dilute it more. So you can go up to 8.6 fluid ounces of product, but then you'll need to use 4 gallons of water. But both of those cover 1,000 square feet. So it's not me making this complicated. This is the label, but again, it's important to understand this and read it, and that way you understand what you're doing. And so if you do make a mistake, you'll know how and why, or hopefully avoid mistakes. So once again, the low rate on this one is 5.2 ounces into 1 gallon of water, and that is the mix rate that I'm going to use. I'm using the low rate, and therefore I'm going to use a little bit less water. 5.2 ounces into each 1 gallon of water, and that 1 gallon of spray mix will cover 1,000 square feet. Also of note, I should not be spraying over 85 degrees. It's not that hot here today, but it's pretty close. So with that, I'm gonna blanket spray this first 1,000 square foot area, and that's gonna take 1 gallon of spray mix. And then I'm gonna use 1 gallon of spray mix, now this is a guess, to go ahead and do my zone and spot sprays on sections 2 and 3. So that's what I'm doing. That way I only have to mix up 2 gallons of spray mix. So again, 1 full gallon of spray mix is gonna be blanket sprayed on section 1 on the side. And then 1 other gallon will be used to zone or spot spray throughout sections 2 and 3. So that's kind of how that's working out. So I got to mix up 2 gallons of spray mix. And the first thing I'll do after I mix up is show you how to blanket spray, because that's an important thing to do. And then after that, I'll show you how to spot and zone spray, and we'll see where I came up. You understand, I'm using the label, I'm using the coverage rates that I know I should be using, and I'm using logic when it comes to spot spraying, so I mix up the least amount as possible. If I do happen to run a little bit short over here, that's why I've got this here to come in and back up if I need to. I can do that. Or again, you might want to choose this option right here. But either way, let's do that. So let's go now and mix up. So it's going to be 5.2 ounces of concentrate per 1 gallon of spray mix, and I've got a 2 gallon sprayer. Here we go. Always label your sprayer so you know what's in it. That's just a smart thing to do. Okay, so here we are ready to fill. Let me explain to you what I'm gonna do. So here's my pump sprayer, and it's 2 gallons. This is the 2 gallon mark. This is the 1 gallon mark. That's 1.5. So you're all gonna have your different sprayer, but just so you know, I'm putting in 2 gallons of spray mix. The blanket spray on section 1 on that side is gonna use 1 gallon. And then when I come out here and I do these two sections here, that's gonna use the 2nd gallon. So because I'm mixing 2 gallons, remember this is 5.2 ounces per gallon, and 1 gallon covers 1,000 square feet. So we are doing 2 gallons, so we need 10.4 ounces. So this is my fill sheet here that I brought out with me, and I need 10.4 ounces for a 2 gallon fill. I was able to read inside of here, and this goes up to 4 ounces, so I'll do it through using this thing here, but if you have a better measuring cup, you can use it. But just so you know, this is rudimentary and it will work. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to fill the sprayer half full before you mix. So half full of water first. Okay, now blanket spraying. So again, we have a 1,000 square foot area that we're gonna blanket spray. It's on the side over there. And you have to know your pump sprayer, how fast it pumps out. So I'm gonna link in the description below to a video I did a couple weeks ago where we talked about here, where we did a bucket test and where I taught you how to blanket spray a 1,000 square foot area. So you're gonna need to go review that video. But basically what I know is that my sprayer will pump out 1 gallon of spray mix in 4 minutes because I did a bucket test. So again, go check out that video below and read and go back through that. And then again, you'll come back here and you'll understand a little bit better, I'm pretty sure. So again, I have 4 minutes to spray this area over here. Now, it's only 1,000 square feet, and to walk that in 4 minutes would be a very slow walk. So what we do is we just do it in two passes. So I'll go this way on it, and then I'll go this way on it, and it'll be 2 minutes going this way and 2 minutes going this way. And that's why we referred back to here, how we did it here. So I did one pass, 2 minutes going that way and 2 minutes going that way. So that's how you're gonna blanket spray, okay? So I have essentially 4 minutes to get all of my spray mix, 1 gallon of it, out very evenly across this area. Now you're also gonna see that I'm mixing 2 gallons. So when I'm done spraying this area here, I should have 1 gallon left. We'll stop and check. And that extra gallon will be used to do the zone and spot spraying on sections 2 and sections 3. So let's go get it done.
So quick check here. Remember, when we blanket spray, we're gonna go one direction and then the other direction, and we're gonna take 2 minutes each time according to the sprayer. So I'm halfway through my first direction here, and you can see I gotta get to there. So I'm doing pretty good because I got a couple more swaths left and I'm there. And then I'm gonna go back the other direction, and when I end up, I'll be down here, and that's my blanket spray of 1,000 square feet. Also, the way this thing is shaped, if you're looking at it visually, you might think that's way more than a gallon, but it's not. It's just that this is fatter on the bottom. So that's a gallon there, and that's another gallon there. I marked this one for the half because this is my blanket spray monitor.
So you can see here our first pass is one half a gallon, so we're right on. Now we're gonna go back the other direction and we're gonna use up the next half gallon. So that's how you do it, 1,000 square feet, 1 gallon. So here we go, now we're going that way. So looks like we're pretty good. It's leaning a little bit, but it's close. So there you go, there was the blanket spray. And again, to reiterate, what I did is I took the first pass,
and I went that way. That was a half a gallon. Then the second pass, I went that way. That was a half a gallon to give me 1 gallon across 1,000 square feet. That's how I do it. It took 4 minutes.
So now I'm going to do this next section here, and this is 4,500 square feet through here. But what I'm going to do with this is zone and spot spray. So I basically have 1 full gallon to cover this 4,500, but I'm not going to blanket spray it. So I've already sprayed 1,000 and I kind of know how it feels. I know what it looks like. I know what the output looks like because I stop and check. So now I can just go by feel. And remember, you want to spray the weeds until wet. And because we're at the very lowest use rate here, if you have some areas that are really concentrated, it's okay to get a little heavy-handed in those. Again, because we're at the low use rate, like around edges and stuff, get them a little extra wet. That's okay. Now, definitely one thing to keep in mind when you're zone spraying or spot spraying is you don't have to walk that fast. In fact, you want to take a leisurely walk in the lawn and pay attention. You just walk a logical grid. It's pretty easy to understand. This is why I tell you to learn your land, and this is part of learning your land. Just walk it nice and easy. Keep your eyes open. Keep that wand tip right at knee level. And when you do see some weeds coming up, go ahead and actuate the sprayer. Get them nice and wet, but keep on moving. You don't have to get down in there and zorch them hard or anything like that. However, if you do get to an area where there is a higher concentration, then it is okay to spray a little heavy-handed. And here's how you would do that.
Here's an area right here, you'd probably be able to see it. See how it's light green? That's all brand new nuts edge that came in. So that's like a zone spray area. So it's okay to stop and hit that a little bit harder. Again, we're at the low use rate.
But really, for the most part, guys, this is not a difficult process. Just walk it, enjoy it. Just get out there, put a little music on, enjoy yourself, be logical, be safe, wear your safety gear, and you'll be all good. Some of you might ask me if we need a surfactant here. No, this product doesn't call for one, so I'm not gonna use it. That's something that's, you know, a little bit more advanced. If you're a beginner, don't worry about the word surfactant. Don't worry if you don't use one. Most of the over-counter stuff, you're not gonna need it. They include all that in there for you, so. It's just a sticker is what that is, but don't get wrapped around the axle on it. Don't worry about it. Okay, we'll do some more spot spraying here. This is the Palmetto St. Augustine grass. Got some heavy weeds in here. Okay, well, there you go, guys. It's been a long day. It's, the sun's sort of going down here. It's getting a little bit late, but I need to go get me some fried shrimps. So with that, I really hope this video has been helpful to you. Leave your comments and questions below. I do have full guides that kind of answer all this. In fact, this video is meant to be a support for that guide. So if you're looking for more information, click the links in the description below. I promise you, whether you get on our free email newsletter list or you buy the full guide, you're going to get some help there. We give out a lot of good content either way. So with that, I'm Alan A. in the Lawn Care Nut. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the lawn.